Today we are going to discuss about another important front-end electronic circuit in analog, that is automatic gain control or automatic volume control. Such systems exist in television receivers, radio receivers, almost all communication receivers, and also in hard disk readers, etc., where we are not sure of the level at which the signal gets generated, and therefore even in digital signal, for example in hard disk, the level of ones and zeros might keep on changing, and therefore we want a sort of constant output from these as far as ones are concerned, and zeros are concerned, a lower output or something like that. And in the case of analog signals like IF, RF, etc., the magnitude of these IF, RF depends upon the sensitivity of your antenna and the front-end electronics, the gain, etc. And the signal received keeps on fluctuating, and therefore the output amplitude should not keep varying, okay, with this kind of thing. So we want to make that constant. So let us now establish an voltage controlled amplifier, and the voltage controlled amplifier is nothing but a multiplier. An ideal multiplier is being used, Vx into Vy, which is Vc, control voltage, x into Vy divided by Vr, where Vr is the constant of proportionality of the multiplier. So such precision multipliers with a standardized value of Vr of about 10 volts exist, which can handle signal of the order of plus minus 10 volts. Okay. Now such multiplier is what is being used to demonstrate the this control loop. So this first multiplier is being used as a voltage controlled amplifier. Now you can see that Vx is the input, and we are assuming that the input is a sinusoid, let's say Vpi sine omega t. So this becomes equal to Vc divided by Vr into Vpi sine omega t output. And now we want the peak amplitude of the output Vc into Vpi by Vr to remain constant. And therefore we want to detect the amplitude. So let us call this as Vpo. So this Vpo is applied to both the inputs of the multiplier to detect the magnitude of the input. So it becomes Vpo square divided by Vr into sine omega t, sine square omega t, which is nothing but there is a DC component in this, which is Vpo square divided by 2 Vr to 1 minus cos 2 omega t. So this gets filtered, and the DC component here, okay, this gets filtered by the low pass filter action of this here, and it responds to only the DC Vpo square by 2 Vr. If we have V reference now as negative voltage, say minus V reference, then what happens is this capacitor will not charge only if this current is same as this current. If the capacitor doesn't charge, then the output of the amplifier remains constant at value E. So now we want this output, okay, amplitude to become equal to V reference, to be equal to square root of, okay, this becomes equal to Vpo square by 2 Vr, or Vpo becomes square root of 2 Vr. That means Vpo remains constant, okay, at a value of square root of 2 Vr by V reference by this arrangement, and therefore whenever there is input changing, Vx is changing, then correspondingly Vc will, if Vx decreases, Vc should increase, so that Vx into Vc by Vr remains constant. Okay, that's all that is doing. This particular control loop is doing that. The moment Vx is decreasing, Vc will increase proportionately, such that the peak amplitude, output amplitude remains constant. Right. So this is what establishes this as an AGC or automatic volume control. So what happens here is you have to plot VPI versus VP0. Initially, of course, the control loop is not functional, okay, because input may be very low and this amplifier is not capable of amplifying it to that extent. So it will be this, because of this negative voltage here, this will go to positive saturation. So this will be at the highest gain possible. So at the highest gain possible, it will keep on increasing. The highest gain is unity in this case of multiplier. Okay. So let's say 10 volts is the saturation voltage and this is 10 volts, the gain is unity. So this is unity. Thereafter, it remains constant at this magnitude until the input amplitude itself exceeds 10 volts, beyond which we are not supposed to apply to the multiplier that magnitude. The multiplier stops functioning as a voltage controlled amplifier thereafter. So this is the range, dynamic range within which AGC is effective. This is the lock range, you can just say that this is the lock range in which this particular AGC loop is getting locked to this particular amplitude at the